Hello friends, I'm back again and this time we are discussing bond order in polyatomic species. How to find bond order in polyatomic species? See, bond order gives an idea about number of bonds. So, if we have CO2, alright, or we have SO3. Alright, or we have SO4, 2 negative, or we have NO3, single negative, or we have PO4, negative, or ClO4, single negative, or ClO3, single negative, or ClO2, single negative, or we have nitrite, or we have ozone, etc., or benzene. See, I told you bond order gives an idea about number of bonds. So if we have two bonds between two atoms, straight away say bond order is two. In SO2, the bond order of S and O, bond order between S and O is 2, because we have two bonds. All right. Now see, for SO4 2 negative, how to solve it? Between SO4, see, for single bond, between this sulfur and oxygen we have one bond, so bond order of S and O is 1. Between these two we have one bond, so bond order is 1. But now, between S and this oxygen, alright, we have one bond, pi bond, and this pi bond can exist between these two, it can exist between these two, it can exist between these two, or it can exist between these two. Alright, so one pi bond can be in resonance with other sigma bonds. So the contribution of these two pi bonds towards bond order, there are two pi bonds and they are in resonance with how many sigma bonds? 4. Or this is 1 by 2. Alright. Or this is 1.5. This is the bond order of S and O. Between S and O in sulfate ion is 1.5. Alright. Look at NO3. This bond is basically coordinate bond, but NCERT considers this bond as coordinate, a covalent bond. So, see, remove the pi bond. Now, between nitrogen and oxygen, we have one bond. So, the contribution of this bond towards bond order is 1. Alright. And now, this pi bond can exist between this oxygen, nitrogen and this oxygen, nitrogen and this oxygen, nitrogen and this oxygen. It is in resonance. So it is 1 plus 1 by 3, that is equal to 1.33. See, for single bond, bond order is 1. For this pi bond, which can exist between, which is in resonance between these four sigma bonds, the contribution of that pi bond towards bond order is 1 by 4, that is 1.25. ClO4, for one sigma bond, the bond order is 1, alright, plus 1, 2, 3, 3 pi bonds are in resonance between 4 sigma bond, contribution is 3 by 4, alright, 1.75. Here, see, for single bond, bond order is 1, For these two pi bonds, which are in resonance with the, these three sigma bonds, the contribution of that pi bond or those pi bonds towards bond order is 2 pi 3. So it is 1.67. Here it is 1 plus this pi bond between these two, 1 by 2, it is 1.5. Here again 1.5. Alright, here again 1.5. Here 6 sigma bonds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Means 1 sigma bond between 2 carbon atoms we are considering. 1 sigma bond plus 3 pi bonds in resonance with these 6 sigma bonds. So the contribution is 1.5. The overall bond order is 1.5. There are special cases also where you have to be careful, like BF3. Look at BF3, boron trifluoride. Here we have only one bond. So it seems that bond order should be one. But you should be careful, between boron and fluorine, we have one back bond. The filled orbital of fluorine overlap with vacant. In vacant orbital of boron to give back bond. Now this back bond is again in resonance between these three. So the contribution becomes 1 plus 1 by 3, that is 1.33. In cases of back bond, you will find this thing. Look at CCl3. Alright, CCl3 single negative. Bond order should be 1, but you should be careful, the filled orbital of carbon, alright, which is having negative charge, overlaps with the vacant d orbital of chlorine. Again, this is in resonance. 1 plus 1 by 3, 1.33. So, wherever there is this back bond, this concept is there. Alright, look at SiH3 whole thrice N. SiH3 whole thrice N. Here also we have one filled orbital over nitrogen and vacant d orbital of silicon, lateral overlapping. Bond order becomes 1.33. Alright. I hope you are enjoying. Subscribe to my channel and my app, that is Win-Win Test. Or you can log in winwintest.com on laptop. There you will find many questions, objective questions you can solve for your examination, for your preparation. Alright.